In this video, we will understand basic introduction of geometry and also see the historical development of geometry. Geometry is a branch of mathematics that help us understand and learn different shapes, objects, and their measurement of length, area, and volume. In geometry, we also learn point, line, and plane. The word geometry is have geometry. Two words, geometry. Geo means earth. And metry means measurement. This is earth measurement. And the first use of geometry by mankind was for measurement of land, farms for the farmer, and also for building canals and waterways for irrigating the farms. It was also needed for building construction, houses, temples, streets, and road. For example, if we have to build some house, then we have to have various measurement taken up front, and plan is made before the construction is done. Similarly, when we are building a bridge, lot of geometrical analysis is required. In the ancient Indian times, the temple required lot of geometrical measurement. The popular Sri Yantra, which has so many isosceles triangles, and also even our altars having different geometrical shapes. So if we look at the historical development of geometry, the geometry evolved in the three main civilization of the world: the Greek civilization, the Greeks also used geometry, Egyptians also used geometries, Egyptian and Indians. And in all these three regions, the geometry evolved. And if we need to understand the historical facts, then we go by timeline. Timeline is also like a number line. The only thing is it doesn't have a zero. There is no concept of a zero year. And it is related to the birth of Christ, and the period before the birth of Christ is called BC, and the period after the birth of Christ is called AD. AD stands for Anno Domini, and BC stands for before Christ. Now, and the first year in which the Christ was born is called year 1 AD, and the year preceding this, so this is plus 1, and the year preceding was minus 1, and that is denoted by before Christ. So there is no zero year. And for example, today we are in year 2012, so this means it is 2012 years after the birth of Christ. So India got independence in 1947. So when we study history, we basically put all the historical facts on the timeline. Timeline is indicating the time horizons, and as we go along, the next year will become 2013 and so on. Now 3000 year before Christ, so that means it's like minus 3000 years. That was the time the Indian civilization was quite mature. And then we have, through the excavation, we have seen that Harappa and Mohenjo-daro, there we have seen that well-planned cities were there as back as 3000 years before Christ. So that means from today almost 5000 years before, where well-planned cities were there, parallel roads, construction done with bricks measuring perfect ratio of 4:2, 4 brick in the ratio of 4:2:1, and also our temples where we have Sri Yantra and altars having different shapes like circle, rectangle, square, triangles, etc. So this is where the geometry evolved in India, starting from 3000 BC, and it continued. The Greek also developed geometry, and this, there was a mathematician with the name Thales. Before Christ. Then there was another mathematician which was 570 years before Christ, and Pythagoras, and he gave us the important Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras. And the triangle, that means the hypotenuse is square of hypotenuse is equal to the sum of the square of the two sides. That means C, and this is A and B. So this is the C square is equal to A square plus B square. Then in year 300 BC, there was a Greek mathematician, the name Euclid. Now Euclid did documentation of various geometrical formulas and principles. So he was among the first person who did the documentation, whereas prior to that the knowledge was being transferred by word of mouth. So that is why we call it Euclid's geometry, because he did the documentation of the various principles and various formula of geometry. So if you look at the geometry, so we know that it is the science or the branch of mathematics which helps us in measurement of various shapes and objects. And the historically it started evolving as earlier as 5000 years from now or 3000 years before Christ. It developed simultaneously by Indians, Egyptians and Greek, and there are a lot of evidences available in all the three civilizations. Egyptians also built pyramids, and building pyramids require a lot of knowledge of geometry. But Euclid was among the first mathematicians who did the documentation of knowledge of geometry, and that is why we are learning this Euclid geometry as a chapter in our class. Thank you.